That's Nick Tudor on drums. That's all by Wayne Shorter out of Newark, New Jersey. And, okay, you can clap for Newark. That's all right. So, if you looked at the program, did anybody look at the program? Okay, 10 people. Thank you. I put a lot of work into that, and 10 people looked at it. So, tonight is about the 1970s. Now, that song was not written in the 70s, but I'm going to connect it to you, the 70s for you just right now. Wayne Shorter was one of the founders of a fusion jazz group called Weather Report. Anybody ever hear Weather Report? Yes. Weather Report was one of the most popular jazz groups in the 70s. And he played on one of the most iconic albums of the 70s, one of the most iconic pop jazz solos on an album called Asia by a group called Steely Dan. So there's your connection to Wayne Shorter in the 70s. Now next, we're gonna go to Sesame Street. This was written by Joe Raposo. We're gonna do the theme song. Now the theme song from Sesame Street has been the theme song, it's the longest running song on that show. Sesame Street, I'm gonna connect to 70 Street. Sesame Street first aired in November of 1969, and it became an American institution by 1975. So right at the end of 69 and going into 70, Sesame Street came out. It was widely acclaimed, very popular, and by the mid-70s, it was an American institution. On that show, one of the first human characters was a person played by Bob McGrath. Now, Bob McGrath lived up in Teaneck, New Jersey, since 1958 all the way to 2016. And Bob McGrath, on Sesame Street, his name was, anybody know? Bob Johnson. And does anybody know what Bob Johnson's job was on Sesame Street? He was a music teacher. Oh. Which makes sense because he got his master's degree in vocal performance from Mr. Priore and my alma mater, Manhattan School of Music. So, Mr. Johnson, played by, yeah. So we thought we'd play a little tribute to Bob McGrath by playing the theme from Sesame Street. Thank you. Donald Grace on the trumpet. That's Owen on the very saxophone. Alright, next we're going to do a song by Oliver Nelson called Stolen Moments. And connecting this to the 70s, in 1971, he moved out to L.A. and became a much sought-after TV and film scorer, composer. He was writing for such shows as Night Gallery, Columbo, $6 Million Man. Does anybody remember any of those shows? Good, so we know who all the old people are. He was also writing for people like Nancy Wilson, Diana Ross, The Temptations. So he became much sought after, but unfortunately died at a very young age of 46, really kind of right at the top of his game. But he died of a heart attack, and people say he worked so hard, he was always so stressed about everything that they think it maybe contributed to his heart attack. So we're going to go back and do a song that he did way before that. It's from an album called Blues and the Abstract Truth, and this is Stolen Moments.
Thank you.
Charlie Parker and Thelonious Monk and a bunch of people were responsible for a kind of a genre called bebop back in the mid-1940s. And to connect this one to the 70s, there was a very famous flugelhorn player in the 1970s who had a really big instrumental hit in 1978. Does anybody know who that was? Chuck Mangione, not Clark Terry, but that was a good guess. Chuck Mangione, right, and Chuck Mangione and people like Grover Washington Jr., Spyro Gyra, Al Jarreau, George Benson, they kind of created this thing called smooth jazz, it became known as, which grew out of that Weather Report and Mahavishnu fusion jazz stuff. And Dizzy Gillespie was friends with Chuck Mangione's family and actually gave Chuck one of his bent up trumpets. If anybody ever have seen the picture of Dizzy and he has that bent up trumpet, he actually gave Chuck, when Chuck was a young 10 or 12 year old, one of those bent up trumpets. And of course, Chuck went on to become one of the great smooth jazz artists of the 1970s and into the 1980s. So that's our connection to the 70s there. This is, we're gonna feature, I think Dylan's got the solo on this one over there on the clarinet. So here's a little Night in Tunisia. Thank you. and Wes over here on percussion. Thank you. We'll be right back.
Open your eyes.
some Elton John for you. This was actually the A side of a... Does anybody know what a single was? Yeah. Okay. Again, all the old people clapping their hands. Don't worry, I'm old too, so it's all right. So this was the A side, and a song called "Your Song" was the B side of that single. Does anybody remember that one? Yeah. Okay. So DJs, does anybody know radio? Okay, some of you do. DJs were what they called people that played the music on the radio station, and they liked your song better than this song that we're about to do. But I like this song equally as well as the song that they liked. And this one is, it comes from his 1970 record, and the lyrics Bernie Taupin wrote, and Elton and Bernie Taupin both have no idea what they really mean. And this song is called "Take Me to the Pilot." And Elton will be portrayed by Dylan. And Elton will be portrayed by Mr. Priori.
I am tempted, and I must spend with my treason.
All right, so I was too young to see the Carpenters in concert, so. We recently lost Burt Bacharach. Does anybody remember Burt Bacharach? Burt Bacharach and Hal David. And in 1970, the Carpenters released this song. It was actually really first released in 1963. And then there was a cover by Dusty Springfield and Dionne Warwick and Herb Alpert also recorded it, but he never released his. He didn't like his recording of it. But he did like the song and decided he convinced the Carpenters that they should record this song. And it became their breakthrough hit and the best-known version of this song. Herb Alpert was supposed to play the little flugelhorn trumpet solo in the middle, but he wasn't available, so they got this studio musician named Chuck Finley and Richard Carpenter, Karen's brother, who also orchestrated this song, kind of showed Chuck Finley, he said, I want you to sound like Herb Alpert. And by the time they did the recording, everybody thought it was actually Herb Alpert on the release of this song. But we're going to do a little bit of the Carpenters. And we have Courtney Tolmie. Are your parents here?
Yeah.
Okay. Courtney told me that you used to sing this to her every night. Oh, they played it. Oh, I thought they sang it for you. Okay. Yeah, okay, good. There you go. All right. So this one is called They Long to Be Close to You.
Time.
So now, we're going to go to a song by Blue Suede, which is actually originally written by, oh, Blue Suede fans, nice. Written by B.J. Thomas. B.J. Thomas fan, okay. There you go. Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head. That's B.J. Thomas. So this one, when I mentioned this before when we played in March, the when I brought this in, I had no clue that these guys knew what this song was, and I said, we might do this one. Oh yeah, we gotta do that one, that's amazing. So, it's from Guardians of the Galaxy, if you don't know anything else. There you go. So this is Hooked on a Feeling. I've seen a lot of concerts. It's my job. So this next one is by another iconic artist from the 1970s, James Taylor. And the seniors thought they'd like to do this song. They were the, so if you don't know the song Fire and Rain, if you don't know the story, it's really three parts. There's the first part where James is talking about the suicide of his one of his childhood friends. And then the second part is battling his own demons with addiction and depression. And then the third part, where the flying machine is crashing on the ground, that's really, people thought that was about an airplane crash that happened, but it's really his band, James Taylor and the Flying Machine, which never really went very far. And then eventually, James was discovered more or less by Paul McCartney and John Asher and Apple Records, and that's how he got his big break. But the seniors, being the freshman class of when COVID hit, thought this was kind of an appropriate song, their own fire and rain that they've dealt with through their journey here. So we're going to do a little James Taylor for you.
Yesterday morning, they let me know you were gone. Susan, the plans they made put an end to you.
Morning, and I wrote down this song. Just can't remember who to send it.
I've seen fire and I've seen rain. Seen sunny days that I thought would never end. Seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. I always thought that I'd see you again.
I was too young to see Gladys Knight also, so that's the business. Now, how do I connect Gladys Knight's version of I Heard It Through the Grapevine, 1970s, because that was released in 1967. Well, here we go. Do my best. Gladys Knight really became popular in the 1970s. So I'm going to say that because their signature hits were created in the 1970s, that we're just going to go back and revisit the one that kind of broke them through. And also, just simply because I like Gladys Knight. So we're going to do a little bit of Gladys for you. Let's see. Am I supposed to bring you guys out on this? Because, no, we're not going to do that. Yeah, let's bring you out. Go ahead. We have Faith playing Gladys. And then the Pips are Dylan, Nick, and Wes. Disco. So, oh wait, go ahead. oh no, I gotta, oh wait a second, I gotta be right back, I'll be right back. But we gotta bring one of our stars out. And are my light people on board ready? Maura, are we good? Where are you, Maura? Are you backstage? Maura, there we go. How can you do disco without a disco ball? McFadden and Whitehead. Now, if you look up over there, you'll see the one that says disco and it says McFadden and Whitehead. So you'll maybe know this. This song was really, they wrote this song, Ain't No Stopping Us Now, and it was really about their dispute with Gamble and Huff and Philadelphia International record label, their royalties, and then, you know, they were arguing whatever. But it became kind of this social commentary and became what was known as the new black national anthem because of the lyrics and the content of the song. They just kind of adopted it as their plea and their cry for, you know, justice. And so we're going to do this song, Ain't No Stopping Us Now, by McFadden and Whitehead.
Spinning your wheels.
we got one more for you, and we need a little bit of time, one more time. So I'm going to do a little bit of thank yous, and then you're going to get involved in a sing-along with us. So first of all my colleagues in the music department here, Mr. Lynch, Mr. Robusky, and Ms. Neville, thank you. Administrative people, our administrative assistants, especially Judy, who printed up our programs for us today. The custodians who clean up after we finish our rehearsals, and we'll have a big cleanup tonight for sure. The jazz parents, thank you for getting, especially the big crew that moved us before us after school. BMPA funding is vital to what we do, so thank you, BMPA. John Priori, over here on the team. For attending tonight, thank you. And those of you that have attended over the 34 years that I've been doing this, if you've been here a few times or, you know, kind of a regular person, thank you. Anyone that has done anything at all, ever, to help this band in my 34 years, I thank you and appreciate everything you've done. My crew is Amanda and Matthew. And without question, after me, the person that does the most, or has done the most for this band, artwork, decorations, painting, bringing stuff when I forgot it, sewing costumes. She made 5 purple suits and 25 Sgt. Pepper outfits, just to give you an example. Making sure our funky shirts are ready to go. Setting up salsa night dinner, setting up our sound check dinner, and then cleaning up after those dinners. Putting up with my insanity and making my absolutely crazy ideas come to life. My amazing and talented wife, Robin, thank you. Now, this is where you get involved because they still need a little bit more time. Thank you so much for doing that. Absolutely. So, one of the artists that also, go ahead, wait.
But they're gonna see you. Oh no.
One of the artists that was also popular in the 70s is Billy Joel. There you go. So we're gonna have you sing along while they're still getting changed. They have one more costume outfit for you for tonight. And, we were going to do, when COVID hit, these freshmen were working on scenes from an Italian restaurant, but we never got to do that, and we never got back to it, and we have not done a Billy Joel, so I thought, well, they still need a few minutes, Mr. Priori and I would play Piano Man for you, but invite you to sing along. Now, we're only going to do 2 verses, because it's really long, and we're just going to do the Saturday verse, the first one, and the last verse, so you can sing along. If you only know the part that goes, play me a song, you're the piano man, then just sing that part. If you know everything, sing along. Okay.
He says, son, can you play me
And the manager gives me a smile, 'cause he knows that it's me they've been coming to see, to forget about life for a while.
Changing world in which we live in. Make-
Thank you so much. We don't have any more songs, so we're done. Go home and eat some cookies or something.